described the natural law theory is Lon Lewis Fuller or Lon Fuller. He is a great supporter of modern natural law philosophy. He is a great supporter of modern natural law. मॉडर्न नॅचरल लॉ और रिवायवल ऑफ नॅचरल लॉ. नॅचरल लॉ मी प्रत्येक वेळी काय म्हणतोय, कारण नॅचरल लॉचा उद्देश हा माणसाच्या चांगुलपणावर किंवा त्याच्या मॅच्युरिटीवर किंवा त्याच्या मॉरल्सवर अवलंबून आहे, इक्वॅलिटीवर अवलंबून आहे. दीज कन्सेप्ट आर मोर ऑफ ह्युमन इन नेचर अँड देअर फॉर द नॅचरल लॉ ज्युरीज हॅज बिलीव्ड ऑन दिस ह्युमन कॅरेक्टर्स ऑर ह्युमन क्वालिटीज रादर दॅन बिलिव्हिंग ऑन द मियर लेटर ऑफ लॉ. And therefore, this natural law is very important to study. Okay, he is a leading supporter of the modern natural law. He emphasized on the role of reason. He emphasized on the role of reason or human reasoning as such. He said, reason or human reasoning, which is a faculty of human mind, which is a faculty of human mind or human consciousness, is the basis of law according to Lon Fuller. Fuller has pointed out that the law and morality are necessarily correlated. This reason and law and morality correlated means without morality law cannot work or law cannot be effective. Thus he denied any rigid separation between the law as it is and the law as it ought to be. Further he said that the positivism and natural law are the two divergent legal philosophies competing at the same time. He pointed out that the essence of legal positivism is a sharp distinction between law as it is and law as it ought to be. Theory denies this rigid separation. The natural law theory denies rigid separation. There cannot be a strict or a watertight separation between law as it is and the law as it ought to be, because mean the time he ka sangtoy Fuller tar jyavel positive theory hi kami padayla lagli ani tyachyamule natural law theory puna revive zali. Natural law theory puna revive ka zali? Because the rigid separation je kay kelele hoto positivism ne te kami padlyamule पुन्हा एकदा नॅचरल लॉ चा विचार करावा लागला. पुन्हा एकदा नॅचरल लॉ जिवंत झालेला दिसून येतो. अँड देअरफॉर ही डिनाइड वी कॅन नॉट सेपरेट द लॉ ऍज इट इज अँड ऍज इट ऑट टू बी. लॉ कसा आहे आणि तो कसा असायला हवा याच्यामध्ये आपण रिजिड सेपरेशन करू शकत नाही. अदरवाइज इट विल कॉज अ ग्रेट कन्फ्युजन इन द एक्झिस्टिंग लीगल सिस्टीम. आपण जर असं रिजिड सेपरेशन करायला गेलो, दिस रिजिड सेपरेशन will cause a great confusion. आणि तेच झालं नेमकं लॉ कशासाठी आहे हेच लीगल सिस्टीमला याला याचा विसर पडला आणि त्यामुळे कन्फ्युजन झालं आणि तिथे देअर वॉज अ क्लॅश इन दी थिंकिंग प्रोसेस ऑर दी आयडियालिझम ऍज सच. फर्दर ही सेड द लॉन फुलर हॅज सेड दॅट द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ मॉरॅलिटी अँड इट्स रिलेशन विथ लॉ इज a great detail. What is said? That the concept of morality means there cannot be a law without morality. The concept of morality and its relation with law is very important one. We cannot deny the morality, because without having morality the law cannot work out in its आयसोलेशन लॉ एकटा काम करू शकत नाही जर तो मॉरॅलिटीवर आधारित नसेल तर मॉरॅलिटी असलीच पाहिजे बट ही डिस्टिंग्विश मॉरॅलिटी फ्रॉम मॉरॅलिटी ॲज इट इज अँड मॉरॅलिटी ॲज इट ऑट टू बी याने परत दोन भाग केलेले आहेत मॉरॅलिटी ॲज इट इज म्हणजे लॉ ॲज इट इज होता इथे लॉ यांनी म्हटलेले मॉरॅलिटी ॲज इट इज अँड मॉरॅलिटी ॲज इट ऑट टू बी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ थिअरी वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द पॉझिटिव्हिझम देअरफॉर इट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट टू कीप इन माइंड दीज पॉइंट्स He distinguished that the Lawn Fuller has distinguished between morality as it is. He said the morality as it is considered as a morality of duty. This is morality of duty. When the law is there, it is our moral obligation. We have to follow that duty. We cannot deny the existing law. Of course, we are thinking how the law should be, how the law ought to be, but we have to respect, it is our duty to follow the law as it is. Law which is made or enacted by the present legislature, that law has to be followed. Whereas the law as it ought to be means a morality of aspiration. It is a morality of aspiration. Aspiration means in future context. Aspiration means future context of the law. The law should be made considering future effects. Morality of aspirations. Okay, further he subdivided moral duties into affirmative actions. Affirmative actions जे रॉल्सने सांगितलं होतं ते पुन्हा या ठिकाणी लॉन फुलरने मान्य केलं आणि त्याने सांगितलं की affirmative action is the aspect of morality of aspirations. Further, according to him, morality of duty, morality of duty, that is law as it is, that is law as it is, includes basic requirements of social living, includes basic requirements of social living. Means for living in the society we have to follow certain duties and observance or following such duty is a basic requirement of social samajat jar jagaycha asel to samajat jagat astana aplyala hya ja kai duty ahe the law as it is jo ahe to follow karna atyant garjecha ahe we cannot say ki amala ha law manya nahi ami dusra law tayar karu dusra law jar tayar karaycha asel तरी जो लॉ सध्या असत आहे तो फॉलो करणं हे क्रम प्राप्त आहे तो फॉलो केला गेलाच पाहिजे अदरवाइज देअर विल बी अ ग्रेट केओस इन द सोसायटी फर्दर ही सेड द मॉरॅलिटी ऑफ ऍस्पिरेशन्स मॉरॅलिटी ऑफ ऍस्पिरेशन्स दॅट इज लॉ ऍज इट ऑट टू बी हे लक्षात ठेवायचं प्रत्येक वेळी ही सेड द मॉरॅलिटी ऍज ऑट टू बी कन्सिडर्ड ऍज अ मॉरॅलिटी ऑफ aspirations. This morality of aspirations is necessary or it means a good life of excellence. Changla aayushya jagne karta matra kay paije morality of aspirations manje apan sadhyacha paristhiti samadhani asla paije sadhyachi ji kay paristhiti ahe kaydachi suvyavasthechi law and order chi ti apan follow kelis paije मात्र याच्यातून आपल्याला चांगलं काय निर्माण करता येईल कशासाठी फॉर गुड लाईफ ऑफ एक्सिलन्स चांगलं आयुष्य जगण्याकरता अजून चांगलं काय करता येईल याचा विचार सातत्याने करणं गरजेचं आहे ओके Further, Lon Fuller believes that the law is a purposive system. According to Fuller, law is a purposive, means for with the certain purpose. The law is in existence for a certain purpose. Therefore, he said the law is a purposive system. The purpose of law is subject human conduct, the control and guidance of legal rules. He thinks that every workable legal system must comply with 8 requirements in order to make the law really effective. Law is a purposive system. And what is the purpose of law? The purpose of law to subject means jithe law asel tithe law follow kelas pahije kasha sathi human conduct the control and guidance the control and effective and workable to make the law. Law is a purposive system. Okay, means you have to follow certain law. Why the law is made? To achieve certain purposes. What is the purpose? To subject the human conduct or to regulate the human conduct. And for making a good law, to make the legal system workable or practicable, it is necessary that law, that legal system should comply with certain requirements. म्हणजे आपण चांगला माणूस असण्याकरता काही गुण आपल्यामध्ये असणं गरजेचं आहे. तसं चांगला लॉ कधी होतो? तर चांगला लॉ हे खालचे 8 घटक जे आता लॉन फुलर सांगत आहेत ते 8 घटक लॉ मध्ये असले पाहिजे तर तो लॉ चांगला होतो असं या लॉन फुलरचं म्हणणं आहे. नाउ व्हाट आर दोज रिक्वायरमेंट्स? रिक्वायरमेंट्स of workable law. Kashasati aahet ya requirements of workable law or practical law. These requirements are, first, there should be definite rules. Now this theory is propounded at the beginning of 20th century. There should be डेफिनेट रूल्स. लॉचे जे काही नियम आहेत हे कसे पाहिजे? डेफिनेट पाहिजे. डेफिनेट प्रोव्हिजन, अदरवाइज देयर विल बी अ कॉस. सेकंड, दीज रूल्स मस्ट बी वेल पब्लिसाइज्ड. दीज रूल्स मस्ट बी वेल पब्लिसाइज्ड म्हणजे प्रत्येक लॉ तयार झाल्यानंतर काय झाला पाहिजे? पब्लिश झाला पाहिजे आपल्या नोटिफिकेशन मध्ये, ऑफिशियल गॅझेट मध्ये. हे त्यावेळी सांगितलेलं आहे लॉन फुलरने, म्हणजे लोकांना ते माहीत पडले पाहिजे विद इन द नॉलेज ऑफ द पीपल. देअर फॉर दीज रूल्स मस्ट बी वेल पब्लिसाइज. देअर शुड बी नो अब्यूज ऑफ रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव्ह लेजिस्लेशन. लेजिस्लेशन हा कसा नसला पाहिजे? रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव्ह नसला पाहिजे. नो अब्यूज ऑफ रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव्ह मीन्स बॅकडेटेड इफेक्ट नसला पाहिजे. लॉ मस्ट बी फ्रॉम द प्रॉस्पेक्टिव्ह फ्रॉम द फ्युचर डेट. नो अब्यूज ऑफ retrospective legislations. Then the rules must be easily understandable. These rules must be easily understandable means every common man can understand what exactly the law is, what exactly rules are, and therefore it should be enacted in a very easy language or layman language. The rules must be practicable. These rules must be practicable means it can be followed by every person. Practicable. Every person has a different capacity, different maturity, and therefore the law should suit, the law should be such that it should be practicable for every person. And it must not require a person to do something which is beyond his power of capacity. Means practical means it should not be beyond power or capacity. Means it is expected that the every person shall follow the law. But when the law will be followed? When that law is practical within the power, within the capacity to follow, then and only that law can be followed. For example, keeping the physical distance, do gaz ki duri. Now it is not possible in every situation. You cannot maintain physical distance or social distancing when you are living particularly in a small houses, and therefore that law was outrightly rejected by the people of India. Okay, then the rules must not be contradictory. There should not be self contradiction, means against each other. The rule must not be contradictory to each other or against each other or inconsistent with any other existing law or inconsistent. The law must not be inconsistent with other existing law. With other existing law means these are the principles of legislation which you have to study in interpretation of statutes. Next, the rules should not be subjected to frequent changes. There should not be frequent changes. The law must be static. The law must be certain. Frequent changes. There must not be frequent changes. जर नेहमी बदल होत राहिले तर लोकांना कळणार नाही नेमका कोणता कायदा फॉलो करायचा आहे, नेमका कोणता रूल फॉलो करायचा आहे. आणि त्यामुळे आताच्या सरकारकडून वारंवार कायदे बदलले जातात. एक जीआर आल्यानंतर त्याचं समर्थन करणारा दुसरा जीआर येतो. याच्यामुळे काय होतं, त्या लॉची जी काही कॅपॅसिटी आहे, पावित्र्य आहे, ते कमी होत. आणि लास्ट वन इज देअर मस्ट बी कॉन्ग्रुएन्स बिटवीन द रूल्स प्रमिलगेटेड अँड देअर ऍक्च्युअल ऍडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. कॉन्ग्रुएन्स मीन्स mitigation of mind, or there should be agreement between the different rules, agreement between different rules and its actual administration. This is very important. You cannot make the letter of law only in the books. You have to implement these laws, and therefore the law will be considered as a good law if it satisfy all these requirements according to Fuller. I hope this is clear to all of you. Therefore, the Fuller has given the principles of legislations. In short, these principles are considered as a principles of legislation. This is the part of interpretation of statute in the next term. Okay, these principles of legislation, how the law should be. If you want to make the law really workable, then we have to follow these requirements according to Lon Fuller. Now the next part, here we have finished the modern theory or modern period of natural law.